we had to do the acquisition. So if you see, after one rain, it's like this, your crane is going to be stuck. You even bring a four-wheel drive, it has to be a very good off-road vehicle to come in, right? So we had to be a bit more innovative. So what we did was we went through a process of what we call collapsing the process. We used a digital approach. So industry standard process, the method is to use a crane to get height to do law studies, line of sight studies. Don't worry, I'll give you all the slides later. You all can download the slides immediately after the session. All right? And so that's the method. Use a crane to do line of sight studies. So the machines we need is a crane, four-wheel drive, a digital SLR, all right, Garmin GPS. This is the traditional approach, proven instruments that can measure, everything will be accurate. Okay. Besides this, there's also a compass, and you know, you put the camera, compass in front of your hand, that kind of things, right? Traditional approach. And then for men, you needed to have a crane operator, you needed to have LOS site surveyor who knows how to do the what is required technically. Okay. And then you needed to have the site acquirer, the person who will talk to the people down there to acquire the site. Different skill sets, yeah? LOS versus the person on the ground. And then you need to have a scheduler to schedule for the crane and arrange for everyone together. The scheduling itself was a nightmare. Okay. And then materials, you need to have balloons and very, very important, access road for heavy cranes. You need to have that. The moment you talk about crane, you need to have access road. Access road means rural, to be very expensive. The cost goes up. The budget that they wanted, we couldn't meet. Okay? So what we proposed was this, and we met a lot of resistance, yeah? Tremendous resistance. They refused to accept it. But this is because this is the way they used to do things, and when we propose, there's always resistance. Anyone, when they propose something new. So what we did was we focused on time, and if you look at the color codes, we focus on the time and money for the same deliverable. Let's put aside your current process. I want to get this done, and this amount of money I'm willing to do. Okay? I'm willing to spend on it. This method, just the crane alone, is between 1,000 to 2,000 ringgit per hire. Okay? 1,000 to 2,000 ringgit. What we did was, we said use a drone to get the height to do the law studies. Get a drone, pick it up. Do the 360, covers all the collectors in the area. I don't have to go one by one. I don't have to have a guy with a balloon anymore. I don't have to bring in a crane. Access road becomes a zero issue. I can bring a sampan to the area, so. Okay? As long as I have electricity and this weather is fine, I can get the work done. So, the machine, drone, tablet, four-wheel drive, or sampan. We used to use some sampans in some area, boats. Man, so now is the skilling up, your digital transformation comes in. Lost site surveyor is now trained on drone skills, how to fly a drone. Within a day, they can master this. It takes practice. If you know how to reverse your car and park properly, not park, saying it, then you can fly a drone. Okay, because it's precision, yeah? One thing about flying a drone is precision. You must go to this height. You must turn north, south, east, west, the angles. You must be able to zoom in to see the collector, the distant collector. And the cameras on these drones at that time was pretty good. Today is even far superior, 3 years later. Okay. So upskill the line of sight person. Site acquirer, still the same. Material, spare batteries. All right. For some areas, the reason we have a four-wheel drive is because then we don't have to bring a genset. Your four-wheel drive is diesel. That itself is a generator, okay, which can power your batteries and all that. So we collapsed the entire process. We saved more than 250,000 ringgit on this project. 100 sites, but 2,000 ringgit at the crane, okay, and then running around multiple areas. Just this alone, we cut down the cost by 250,000. And the time, we compressed the time. It was so fast. All we had to do was, we could acquire, we can go and survey 5 to 6 sites in a day. I just have to go to that location, throw the drone up, because all the studies have been done, just trying to drone up, identify the right collectors, different landowners, and capture the sites. Yeah, so we could do that. So this is one of our success that we did, and after we did this, when we first started doing this, there was a lot of resistance, and then we just said, tell us why it's not accurate. We are showing you the accurate measurements, standard tools, all right? It has its built-in digital compass, variances, standard variances. What is the issue? So we use evidence, database documentation to support that this is the best way to move forward. Today it is standard practice. Yeah, today is standard practice because the speed at which we can deliver sites has been tremendously moved forward. Any questions here?
How far was the collector site from?
6 kilometers. 6 kilometers because we are using 300 megahertz. 300 megahertz, 900 megahertz, sorry. 900 megahertz, 3 kilometers radius at least, right, for 3G and 2G. All riding on the 900 megahertz. Yeah. And why we say 6 kilometers is because we're using Wi-Fi. We'll be using Wi-Fi. Custom Wi-Fi encrypted channels, because rural, minimal interference. The only interference you get is oil palm estates. That's where you get the interference, and then we go down, we do our surveys, we do our scanners, and then we'll identify the interference spots, and we adjust our channel hopping accordingly. All right, so yeah. Any other questions? Does this answer your any doubt, you think? Anything else?